This filament dryer has got a pretty cool trick up its sleeve. You can dry your filament right in this box, seal it up, and then store it. Now, this isn't the first company to try something like this. Polymakers got their own version, but this one from Chitu Systems adds some extra features that make it worth checking out. The Chitu Filapartner E1 can dry up to 4 rolls at once, and each box holds up to 2 rolls. So you can even set each box to different temperatures while drying. Now that's great if you're drying different materials, though honestly, I don't think that's something most people do very often. It does top out at 70 degrees Celsius, which is plenty for everything from PLA to polycarbonate. Setting up is easy, thanks to its touchscreen and its built-in drying profiles. That said, it's not a great touchscreen. Chitu went with a resistive design instead of a capacitive one for the screen, so you have to press a little bit harder to make those selections. It works fine, but it does feel a bit cheap, like one of those cost-saving moves that slightly hurts the user experience. Now, I haven't really been able to test this next part yet. Chitu claims that it can automatically start drying when humidity goes over 50% and stops once it hits 25. Okay, it's a cool idea, but in practice, I'm not really sure how often people will actually use that. And if I'm wrong, let me know down in the comments below, because let's be real, you're gonna let me know that anyways. One feature that is pretty useful though is its pressure sensor safety switch. If you lift a box off its base, it'll automatically shut off the heater, which is a nice touch. At $149, this isn't cheap, but it is right in line with the Sunloot S4, which can also dry 4 rolls. The Filapartner's big advantage is that it can swap out storage boxes. Each one holds 2 rolls instead of 1 like the Polymaker version, so you can seal them up between prints and keep your filament ready to go. The Polymaker's version is also $30 per storage box, but with this you do get double the storage versus the Polymaker version. Now, which one's better? I couldn't tell you. I've never played with the Polymaker one yet. Maybe we could fix that in the future. Let me know. Chitu Systems did send this out for review, but they did not sponsor this video. Who really sponsored this video is my members on Patreon, which you can go check out down in the description below if you want to help this channel grow. I'd appreciate that. At the end of the day, it's a filament dryer. If it reliably dries your filament, then that's all that really matters. Still, those extra storage and automation features, they're a nice bonus. And if you didn't know that even brand new rolls of filament need drying, you should check out this video right here. It might surprise you.